Right, so continuance of this whole Chinese astrology. We'll go with the feng shui. Now, I don't have the answers for it aside from look at the chart of north, south, east, west in your house. Look at where it's located, where the north is. And for this year, north is the year of the dog, is the bad area, and that's where you need the salt cure. I just made one, so I need to make another one. It's salt, rock salt or Epsom salt, normally rock though, with 6 Chinese coins, characters up, and you. 3/4 filled, and then with water, and then what happens over time? Those coins, they grow and they collect in the negative ions in the air, negative discharges. And apparently, on north side, this year is extreme, so we're gonna have a. It starts to become like those cave stalactite coral looking, and they need to be changed like maybe 2 or 3 times a year or even more, depending on how much negative energy you've got in your room or in your house. So yeah, so we're talking about the serious make your salt cure. Yeah. So it's pretty heavy right now on the north side, and they call it the Three Killings, that area. So it's very serious in Chinese law as a danger zone. We have danger areas in the feng shui. And then you have others. You have others that are prosperous. It's like never, you're not supposed to sit ever with your back to the north in this time frame, because that would be wrong. You just need to face it or avoid it. But yeah, no big, you're not supposed to dig there, you're not supposed to do construction there, you're not supposed to have heavy disturbances there, no door slamming there. If you have a door that slams in the north, facing north direction on the compass, then my gosh, you have to put quieters on it. Softener, so it's not so loud. And so in a way I kind of like it. I just gave my dad a salt cure in his room, and hopefully that negative energy will change. But anyway, yeah, I don't really like my relatives at the moment. They're a little what do we call it, grabby for possession. And then I'm like, well, which ones? And I was like, well, are they roosters? Yeah, the roosters are grabby for possession. And it's odd because I've had roosters in my life, and I'm like, well, what is causing them to be this way? What's causing them to be grabby for things, wantful, and not just say, hey, you know, I don't really need it, I don't want it, it's yours, and just leave it for its purpose. Why are they just so takey? They'll just take on a whim. And I'm like, well, when you see them out in the field, you see them in the meadow, I've seen them catch little mice, I've seen them catch little lizards, and they'll grab at them and they'll run. But normally it's a hen. It's not the rooster. Normally it's the hen. Very, very rarely you'll find the rooster will find something in his mouth that's unusual, a big slug or salamander. Very rare. It's usually always the hens. They go, ha ha, look what I have. You know? So it's interesting that the roosters are in this phase now also. So it could be, maybe it goes down to testosterone drop. Could be that, you know, that afterlife crisis in men that are roosters. They start to become more hen hen characteristics. Yeah. So if you want to know what the elderly rooster males are like, watch the hens on these videos. A lot of people have their hens out there on video, and they have their roosters. So yeah, you can go. Yeah, interesting. Anyhoot, so yeah, keep your salt cures, and they have the other one with the six coins. That's another one to stop the negative energy. And when I say negative, I don't mean financial, I mean negative energy, like hateful energy. People try to hurt you energy. I really mean negative energy, stop. And so we're facing it here in the West. We're facing it here in the Dantadian, in the North. So the West and the North are getting hit hard. And this year the East is up for robbers. So the East of your house is the one that don't put anything of financial value or greatness there. It'll be more alluring somehow. That energy will be more alluring to bring them into your house to rob you. And I'm looking over here on my wall and there's nothing there. Nothing there. Thank goodness. Okay. Anyway, so let's keep all of these things fun. And yeah, and I believe that applies to pretty much everybody. Doesn't matter if you're the snake sign. Or the what? Yeah. Yeah, it doesn't matter if you're the snake sign or the bad luck star this year is the North. Woo. That's what they call it, the bad luck star. So yeah. We don't want it. We don't want that bad luck star at all to gain momentum, to grab a hold of even of a conversation. You just don't want the bad luck star around. But yeah, we have the South is good. We have romance, and then we have the academic star. So that might be really good for college kids, romance and academics all together. Sounds like the South is very good in there. In that, remember the way this is done, though. This is all in your house. You have to think about this is in your house, in your room. You can do room by room, and then the whole house as well. So we have the favorable star is a very good one. Now that's Northwest, so that's helpful, because that's the away from that bad luck star. The West though is bad, because it's the illness. Your illness, your health is in the West. So, and this is all because of the year of the dog. Now the numbers, I guess they change next year with the who's next on the zodiac. We have is it the monkey? Come on. I believe it's the monkey. Where's the dog? No, I'm sorry, it's the pig. The pig is next. Yeah, so the pig should have different lucky numbers. So maybe they are. This will rearrange of the house a little bit, but the Northeast is the quarrelsome star. So not supposed to put anything in the Northeast that you want to move a lot. You put things there, put very few things there, and they should be very lucky instead of, because they just keep bringing in negatives and more negatives. So yeah, so stay away from the Northeast of your house also. So the Northeast and the North are getting hit hard, and the East. The prosperity luck star is Southeast. And what else do we have here? We have the multiplicative star. Now I haven't read about the multiplicative star, but I guess it's important. It doesn't necessarily mean good, it doesn't necessarily mean bad. It sounds to me like, straight off the bat, anything in that energy space will be multiplicative. If it's a good moment, it'll be drama, therefore more. If it's a bad moment, it'll be drama, therefore in that direction. So multiplicative is sounds like a kind of a drama area. And celestial star is in the southwest. Celestial. Now, celestial normally is to do with spiritual calm. So anyway, so what was I talking about? I don't know. I guess I'm disappointed with roosters today. And they're supposed to be my buddies, but I don't know. I have a feeling they flip-flop and turn into hens later in their lives. So, too bad. Alrighty. Ciao, Bellas out there. Ciao. That's all I've got for tonight. Go look up your... they also call them your flying stars. They call them the flying stars. Yeah.